So in previous class, we discussed about the charge in semiconductor. We discussed the expression for QC prime, the charge density in the semiconductor. Okay, so QC prime was equal to minus signum psi s. Psi s was the surface potential. Into 2q epsilon s into Na. Na is the channel doping multiplied by square root of phi t e to the power minus psi s by phi t. The terms coming out from holes that were present in the semiconductor plus psi s minus phi t because of the psi s minus phi t because of the fixed acceptor or donor ions in the semiconductor and plus e to the power minus twice phi f by phi t into phi t e to the power psi s minus twice phi f upon phi t minus psi s minus phi t minus psi s minus phi t. These two terms will also be in the bracket. Okay, so we discussed this expression in the previous class, and I told you that this signum function is here to address the direction of the electric field, and Na channel doping, psi s the surface potential. Surface potentials we have already discussed. The potential at the silicon-silicon dioxide interface with respect to the neutral region of the semiconductor. Phi t is temperature equivalent voltage. Okay. So we discussed that there are three terms, the total terms of this square root can be categorized into three category: first, second, and the third. Okay, and we discussed the origin of these terms, why these terms are present in this expression. Okay, and then we try to plot the QC prime versus psi s. So the charge density QC prime can be, any question?
Actually, one of the student is trying to join, asking you to join the meeting if you can accept him.
Okay. Anybody else still left? If you can see here, we have already derived one expression for QC prime. QC prime has already been expressed in terms of surface potential, the weak expression. Minus signum psi s square root of 2q epsilon s Na into square root of phi t e to the power minus psi s by phi t plus psi s minus phi t plus phi t e to the power psi s minus twice phi f by phi t minus psi s minus phi t. So this expression is already derived for MOS capacitor system. Okay, the first one here, the gate to body voltage VGV can be written as a psi ox plus psi s plus phi ms. We have already discussed it is nothing but our potential balance expression. So gate to body voltage can be expressed, can be related here with other potentials using this potential balance equation. Charge balance equation, we have already know QG prime plus QO prime plus QC prime must be equal to zero. Apart from that, we can also write this expression for the charge at the gate, because we know that the oxide capacitance is COx prime, which is epsilon Ox upon TOx, and the potential drop across the oxide is psi Ox. So we can relate the gate charge with the potential drop across the gate, and this expression QG prime. QG prime is can be written as COx prime into psi Ox. So here we have four expression. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, and there are of course four unknown. Okay, so four equation, four unknown. Theoretically, we can actually solve this the set of four equations, and we can determine all those four parameters. But if you look at the nature of this expression, for example, here QC prime is written in terms of psi s, and this is such a complicated expression. So it will be very, very difficult to find out the expression for, let's say, QC prime in terms of get to body voltage directly. Okay, it will be difficult because the nature of the expression, there are four sets of equation and four unknowns, and with a one known complicated expression, it will be really very difficult to obtain independent equations for all these four unknown. Okay, so what are those unknown parameter here? Of course, the known parameter is get to body voltage that we have already applied. Okay, and then phi ms is again known to us, and qo prime is unknown to us. Okay, qo prime is known to us, vgb known to us, phi ms known to us, and cox prime known to us. Other parameters you can say are unknown, and they need to be determined from these four equations. But as I said, that solving these four equations to get these unknowns will be complicated. However, we will try to first plot the charge surface potential versus gate to body voltage, or we can choose to use a graphical method to get a solution of these equation to determine one or two parameters. Okay, later on we'll take some simplified case, and based on those cases we'll try to simplify these equations. Okay, so let us see how we can relate the surface potential with gate to body voltage first. Okay, so you have to look at this using the charge balance equation. Here we can start with the charge balance equation. QG prime plus QO prime plus QC prime, this is equal to zero. Okay, so the QC prime here can be written in terms of QG prime and QO prime. The semiconductor charge density can be expressed in terms of gate charge density and the interfacial charge density. QG prime, as we already know, that is nothing but COx into epsilon, COx into psi Ox. The gate charge is COx into psi Ox. This was the fourth equation of the four equations. Okay, the set of four equations. So we can use this here, and we'll get this COx prime minus into psi Ox minus QO prime. Okay, psi Ox again we can invoke here the potential balance equation. The potential balance equation says that VGB equal to psi Ox plus phi ms, okay, plus psi s. Okay, so from this expression we can am I right, phi ms, this is phi ms. Okay, so psi Ox here is nothing but VGB minus phi ms minus psi s. So that's what is written here. You can see that using the potential balance equation, potential balance equation is used here. Okay, and we'll be able to write down this expression BGB minus IS minus phi MS minus QO prime. Okay, now we can take this QO prime inside this bracket, and since UX is taken out here, so we'll have this UX prime in denominator. Okay, so what we are going to see here is minus UX prime into VGB minus psi s, the surface potential, minus phi ms minus QO prime upon CUX. Okay, and now if you see the last two terms of this equation, the last two terms here are together nothing but the flat band voltage VFB. Okay, so VFB is the flat band voltage, and that can be substituted here. Okay, so if you do so, then here we get the total semiconductor charge density QC prime is equal to minus UX prime VGB minus psi s minus VFB. Okay, so QC prime here, the total charge density is written in terms of surface potential here. Okay, so we have got a very straightforward relation between QC prime and psi s. There was another expression in QC prime and psi s. We already had QC prime was a function of psi s, that bigger expression for the charge density. So now we can use these two expression for QC prime function of psi s, and this QC prime can be used graphically together, and we can find out the surface potential value and charge density for a, let's say, given gate to body potential. Okay, so here you can see that how the two expressions are used together to determine the value of QC prime and the surface potential for the given gate to body voltage. Okay, so if gate to body voltage is given, which is, let's say, VGB. Okay, so we can the expression from the expression QC prime equal to F1 of psi s, that bigger expression for the QC prime. Okay, we can draw this QC prime variation with the surface potential. Okay, and then we can use the second expression of QC prime, which was equal to minus COX into VGB minus psi s minus VFB. Okay, generally in standard form we write it in this fashion: minus COX prime, then VGB minus VFB will come first, and then minus surface potential psi s. Okay, so if we plot QC prime here, because QC prime with surface potential against the surface potential, what you can see that there will be a linear, this is a linear relation between QC prime and psi s, and QC prime, if you plot, and you can also see the slope is positive and equal to CUX, because QC prime is minus UX prime minus psi s. So the slope is positive and the slope is CUX. So here is basically QC prime is drawn versus psi s for a given value of gate to body voltage. Please note that this expression, why we need this second expression, because this first expression for QC prime, this is not a function of gate to body voltage. So this is not a direct function of gate to body voltage. So we don't know how gate to body voltage is directly controlling QC prime. However, gate to body voltage will control psi s, and the psi s will control the charge density here. So in this expression, there is no VGV. So we cannot have this information of, we cannot say that for a given VGV, what will be the value of QC prime and psi s. Okay, so that's why we need another expression for QC prime, which includes both surface potential as well as gate to body voltage. Okay, so but an ideal equation would be that this QC prime should have been written in terms of VGV, but here we have expression for QC prime that includes both VGV and psi L. So we can use this expression along with this expression, and we'll be able to find out a solution. So for a given gate to body voltage, VGV minus VFB, VGB and VFB, you can see that the intersection of these two point will be actually solution, and we can find out the QC prime value and the surface potential value. Okay, so graphically we can determine QC prime for a given VGB. If we plot this for a different VGB value, then of course this curve will shift in this direction or in this direction depending upon the magnitude of VGB, and we'll have another let's say intersection point, and there will be new solution. So new surface potential and new new surface potential and new charge density can be obtained. But in this case, you see that the line which is drawn here, the slope will basically cut this surface potential at VGB minus VFB, because at this when psi s is when psi s is equal to 0, when psi s, the surface potential is equal to 0, then the QC prime is equal to minus UX into VGB minus VFB, and when QC prime is 0, means when charge is 0, then in that case psi s becomes equal to VGB minus VFB. So this line is basically indicating zero charge, because here you see that the y axis is QC prime. So charge is 0 at this point along this line, you can say. So when charge is 0, then the surface potential value is equal to VGB minus VFB. So that's why this point here is VGB minus VFB, and when we change VGB, this curve will either shift left or right, and the intersection of this straight line and this QC versus surface potential curve will provide us information about QC prime and the surface potential prime, surface potential value. But of course, this is a graphical method. Okay, and to get more physical insight, we have to revisit the expression for the charge density QC prime. Okay, so here you see that the QC prime expression that we derived earlier, QC prime and surface potential, which is relating QC prime with the surface potential, minus UX, VGB, minus VFB, minus psi s. Okay, so from this expression, we'll be able to write down the surface potential psi s in terms of gate to body voltage. Okay, so psi s here is VGB, because this is minus sign, so this can go to the left hand side, and then CUX prime will be divided here to the right hand side, and we'll be left with the following expression: VGB minus VFB plus QC prime psi s upon CUX. Okay, so here we can express psi s in terms of QC prime in this little bit different form, and since we already have again we can rearrange the terms here, and we will have now VGB equal to psi s plus VFB minus QC prime psi s upon CUX. Okay, This is again nothing but the rearranging the terms of this equation. VGV has taken to the left hand side, and the other terms are clubbed together in right hand side of this equation. So VGV here is psi s plus VFB minus QC prime psi s upon COX. QC prime in terms of psi s has already been expressed, okay, has already been derived. So QC prime can be taken out from that expression. So QC prime is substituted here. So VGB plus VFB plus psi s, now it's become plus, because QC prime was with minus sign. QC prime was minus signum psi s, so minus minus becomes plus. Signum psi s is still as it is, okay, but you see here a new term gamma. The new term gamma is coming out because gamma in QC prime there was a term 2 Q epsilon s into Na, okay, and here we have this COX. So this is divided by COX, so square root of 2 Q epsilon s Na by COX is noted as gamma here, which is nothing but the body effect coefficient. Okay, please note that this gamma is body effect coefficient, and this is a function of the doping in the substrate and the gate oxide capacitance, okay, which is epsilon ox upon tox, which is cox prime. And the other terms here in this expression are similar to what we have seen in the charge expression QC prime. So phi t electronic hole, and this is phi t into e to the power minus psi s by phi t, plus these two terms plus this third term, okay. So these terms have come as it is. The only a new term we see here is this gamma, and this gamma is because of this square root of 2 q epsilon s n upon cx prime. This is a very very important parameter. The body effect coefficient is an important parameter, and you must see here that what are the two parameters that can control this body effect coefficient. So other terms are constant, q epsilon s and COX can further be written as epsilon OX upon TOX. So epsilon OX is again a constant, okay. So if the values of all constants are substituted, then this body effect coefficient gamma can be written in terms of oxide capacitance and the doping level Na, okay. So if we increase the oxide thickness, if we fix other parameters of MOS capacitor, if the doping level is same and the metal work function is same and other parameters are constant except the increment in the oxide thickness TOX. So if TOX is increased, then gamma increases, and also if the channel doping is increased, gamma will increase, but not with the same rate as it increases with the oxide thickness TOX. So higher oxide thickness, larger this body effect coefficient, higher the channel doping, larger this body effect coefficient, okay. The physical significance of this body effect coefficient will be we can say more when we'll be talking about the MOS transistor, okay. MOS, when we'll be talking about the MOSFET, we'll have to discuss about this body effect coefficient in the detail. But here I have introduced this, and you must keep in your mind, you must bear in your mind what are the parameters that can affect this body effect coefficient. So two parameters, one is oxide thickness and another is the channel, or another is the substrate doping, okay. The two parameters can affect the body effect parameter gamma, okay. Here you can see the body effect parameters are actually plotted. Gamma is plotted versus the doping, and this is also plotted for the different value of TOX. Okay, so for a given value of TOX, if you increase NA, then the body effect coefficient will increase. You can see like this. Okay, and if we increase TOX, then you can see that the body effect coefficient will further increase. So this is the nature of the graph. You can see how gamma varies with the doping and the oxide thickness. Okay. Now come back to our earlier discussion. So we were basically talking about, we are here one relation which was relating the gate to body potential with the surface potential. You see, the previous relation, the first one, was where the charge density was related with the surface potential. Now here we have been able to write down the surface potential psi s in terms of gate to body potential VGB. Okay, so we can plot, if we can plot now the surface potential versus gate to body voltage, okay, with the help of this expression. So it is a good idea to plot to vary the surface potential and plot VGB minus VFB. It will be easier because if we vary, if the VGB is varied and then we plot psi s, we'll be end up with a very, very complicated expression, and only that could be done with the help of some sort of computer simulation. But if you go otherwise, if you vary the surface potential, if you take a range of value for the surface potential, and then using this expression, if we try to find out VGB minus VFB for that value of surface potential, that can be done easily, and we'll be able to get the following graph if we use this expression to determine the surface potential, to relate the surface potential with the gate to body voltage. Here you see how the surface potential psi s varies with gate to body voltage VGB. Okay, so the expression that I had shown earlier in the previous PDF page was actually used here to plot psi s and versus VGB. And what you see here, that here in this region, the surface potential is negative. Okay, so this is our accumulation region. You know that in accumulation, the surface potential becomes negative. Okay, surface potential is less than zero. Okay, and in depletion and the inversion region, the surface potential is basically positive. So, and this surface potential is varying from 0 to F to twice F to even a higher value. Okay, so in depletion region and the inversion region, surface potential for positive VGB minus VFB, the surface potential becomes positive. And if you see the nature of this curve, then again you will note one interesting thing. Now if you look at the accumulation region, then you can see here the surface potential is not increasing rapidly with gate to body voltage. Okay, you see that for a large change in the gate to body voltage, there is a small change in the surface potential, only this much. Okay, so in accumulation, surface potential does not change at a rapid rate, at a faster rate, when we change gate to body voltage, unlike the charge. Okay, if you recall how the charge was varying in the accumulation region with the surface potential, for a very small change in the surface potential, the charge concentration was increasing exponentially at such a high rate. Okay, so these two things are contrasting. A very small change in the surface potential will lead to a very, very large change in the charge density in the accumulation region. Okay. However, if we concentrate in depletion region, so in depletion region with VGB, you can see that the surface potential changes significantly. Okay. The change in the surface potential, the rate of increment in the surface potential is higher in the depletion region and the early inversion region, you can see, unlike the case of the charge versus the surface potential. In charge versus surface potential curve, you can see that the charges increases at a slow rate in the depletion region and in early inversion, and when strong inversion is achieved, then only the charge increases at a significant rate. So in this region, from depletion to early inversion, peak inversion, okay,
sir,
you can, yeah
sir, screen is not shared, sir.
Is it?
Yes, sir.
I don't know if this for how. So I was just telling you that how the behavior of the surface potential versus gate to body voltage is different from the charge with the surface potential. Okay, so the charge variation with the surface potential psi s, okay, that can also be plotted here, QC prime versus psi s. And you see that here in the accumulation region, when you change the gate to body voltage VGB, the surface potential does not change at a fast rate. So for large change in the gate to body voltage, you can see there is a very small change in the surface potential here. Okay, so in this range, in the accumulation, surface potential psi s does not change significantly with gate to body voltage VGB. Okay, whereas the charge in accumulation region changes significantly with the surface potential, in fact the charge increases exponentially with the surface potential. Okay, so although the gate to body voltage variation leads to small change in the surface potential, but that small change in the surface potential will be able to give rise to a huge change in the whole concentration, charge concentration in the accumulation region. Okay, this is chronology. Means for a small, for a large change in VGB, okay, large change in a VGB, there is a small change in the surface potential, but this small change in the surface potential will lead to the larger change in the charge density QC prime in the accumulation region. Okay, whereas in the depletion region, you can say that when VGB changes gate to body voltage, there is a significant change in the surface potential. In depletion region, the surface potential changes from 0 to 5F, and then in early inversion from 5F to twice 5F. So in depletion and early inversion, the surface potential change is significant. Psi s change is significant here. So for a smaller change in the gate to body voltage, there is a significant change in the surface potential. Again, but however, in strong inversion, when the surface potential is above this twice phi f, so I am talking about this region. So in this region, again, the surface potential does not change significantly with gate to body voltage, just like the accumulation region. So behavior of you can see surface potential behavior in accumulation region and in the strong inversion region is almost similar. Even in a strong inversion, the surface potential does not change significantly with gate to body voltage. And also if you investigate the charge behavior in the depletion and the early inversion, The charges, charge density does not increase significantly with get to body voltage. But when the surface potential reaches to twice phi f after certain value, after psi s reaches to a little bit higher than this twice phi f value, the charge density changes suddenly. Okay, all of a sudden it increases at a faster rate. And you can see that the increment in this region, in strong inversion region, is almost similar to that of increment in the accumulation region. So both in accumulation region and in strong inversion, charge density increases at a faster rate with the surface potential. But surface potential itself does not change at that fast rate with get to body voltage. However, in depletion region and inversion region, the surface potential changes significantly with the get to body voltage, but charge does not change at such a higher rate with the surface potential in the depletion and the early inversion case. Okay, so the two curves are actually the behavior of QC prime with psi s and the psi s with VGB are actually contrast each other. Okay, they we have in a different fashion. Okay, so I hope I have made this point. Okay, and it is clear to all of you. If you have any question, any doubt, please feel free to ask. Anybody, if have any question, please let me know. Okay, is it clear to all of you? Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so psi s versus VGB curve is here. Okay, and QC versus psi s curve is here. So if you can use the two curves together, okay, then we'll be able to find out QC versus VGB. Can we do this? We have one relation where QC prime is directly related with surface potential. This was the first expression that we derived. Then we derived an expression where VGB could be written in terms of surface potential. Okay, so surface potential seems to be an intermediate parameter here. Okay, so we can take a range of surface potential and we can compute the corresponding value of QC prime and VGB from these two expressions. Okay, and then we can plot QC prime versus VGB. So with the help of those two expression, okay, with the help of QC prime versus surface potential expression and with the help of VGB versus surface potential expression, we will be able to plot QC prime, the charge with respect to get to body voltage directly. Okay, and the nature of the curve is going to be like this. Okay, so you can see here the charge QC prime directly plotted with respect to VGB minus VFB. So in accumulation, you can see the charge increases at a faster rate exponentially with get to body voltage. In depletion and inversion, the charge doesn't change at such a faster rate, and after a strong inversion, this really takes off and again charge increases exponentially with get to body voltage. Okay, so this is the method you can adopt to plot QC versus VGB. Okay, so here is an exercise problem. Okay, you can consider that you can actually take as a homework. Let us say that there is a MOS capacitor here. Okay, and this MOS capacitor is basically, this is a metal work function, metal as a gate here, and the metal work function phi m is let's say 4.7 electron volt. Okay, oxide thickness TOX is let's say 10 nanometer, and the doping here in silicon region, semiconductor region, is let's say that 10 to the power 18 per centimeter cube, and this is of course a p-type semiconductor, p-type semiconductor. Okay, interfacial charge density here can be considered. Let's say that the interfacial charge density is 10 to the power 10 number of charges per centimeter square area. Okay, so for the given data, you have to plot the QC prime versus surface potential, then you have to plot QC psi s versus VGB, and finally you have to plot QC prime versus VGB. Okay, so you can write down the codes in MATLAB and you can take a suitable range for psi s. Okay, doping value is given here. Okay, Na, so from this you can compute phi f. So you can have the idea of phi f value, and then the idea of twice phi f. Okay, so surface potential even increased beyond this twice phi f, the rate increases significantly. So let's say that the maximum value for phi f you take 3 phi f. Okay, and the negative one here psi s, maybe you can vary from minus phi f. So the surface potential range you can take from minus phi f to 3 phi f, and for this range you can plot q prime, then you can plot VGB, you can plot psi s versus VGB. So for VGB you can take a suitable range for VGB, and you can plot psi s, or for this psi s variation only you can determine the VGB range, and you can plot VGB versus psi s, and then finally you will have to plot the charge density QC prime versus get to body voltage. Okay, so this is a home exercise. You can take it, you can write MATLAB codes, and you can simulate your code, and then you can produce graph, and you can submit that to me as a home assignment. So everybody will take here I have given the doping 10 to the power 18 per centimeter cube. Okay, so everybody can take a different value. Okay, let's say x into 10 to the power 18 doping level per centimeter cube. Okay, so someone can take 1 into 10 to the power 18, 2 into 10 to the power 18, as per your last roll number you can take this, the first number, and second is you can consider 10 to the power 17 per centimeter cube. Okay, the last two digit of your roll number could be x multiplied by 10 to the power 17 per centimeter cube. If your last two digit is 00, then you can take any arbitrary number. Okay, but if your last two digit is not 0, then you can take your roll number, and you can have a doping value Na, and for that doping value you can plot these graphs through the MATLAB. Okay, and you will submit that to me. So this is a home exercise for all of you. All right, any question, any doubt so far, feel free to ask. Any question from anybody? Shall I go ahead now? Okay, so far basically we have been able to plot QC prime. We have been able to plot QC prime versus psi s. Okay, then we had a relation for relating get to body voltage with surface potential, and then we had another relation that can, with the help of that, we'll be able to express the charge density with get to body voltage. Okay, so there was not direct relation, but these two relations were used to find out the graph for QC prime versus VGB. And also you see here that the VGB, there is no restriction on the VGB. We are considering a wide range for gate to body voltage. Okay, for and for that and we also, we are not having any restriction on the psi s. Depending upon the arbitrarily taken value of gate to body voltage, we can have any surface potential value, and for that surface potential value we are trying to get the QC prime, the charge density. Okay, but of course this is a complicated exercise, because you have to plot graphs. Okay, you have to take intersection of the two curves, and then you will be able to determine the parameters here. Okay, so what can we do? Rather than doing the analysis in this fashion, where we have basically the general relations for QC prime. You see, the same QC prime here can be predict the charge density irrespective of the substrate being in accumulation or depletion or in inversion. Okay, but if we, let's say, specifically concentrate on a single region, then we'll be able to simplify the expression for the charge density QC prime. Let's say that we target only accumulation region. Okay, so if we target only accumulation region, then the terms which are related to the impurity doping, and the terms which are related to the electronic concentration, that those terms will not be effective and can be neglected. And then we'll have a simplified expression for the QC prime. For example, if we concentrate on the accumulation region only, so you can see here that how in the accumulation region the charge density expression can be simplified. Okay, so here is the charge density expression QC prime, and this is the general expression. Okay, if you recall. All right, based on our discussion so far, we already know that in accumulation, surface potential is less than zero, surface potential is negative. Okay, so considering the surface potential is less than negative, less than zero, our surface potential is even if positive, then it's very small. Okay, we can look at the different terms. Okay, so if surface potential is let's say negative and large, okay, large and negative, then you see that this term will dominate, because we are considering a negative surface potential. So negative negative becomes positive, and the exponential terms become significant, so this term becomes large, whereas this term psi s will be small compared to this term, because this is phi t exponential minus psi s by phi t, and this is minus this is plus psi s with a small psi s value. So compared to this term is very small, and this can be dropped, this can also be dropped. Okay, and now look at this, this is actually phi t e to the power psi s upon phi t, and we are considering a negative surface potential, we are considering psi s less than 0. So this exponential term again become very small, and this can also be neglected. So when we consider that the MOS capacitor is in deep accumulation, deep accumulation means the surface potential is negative and large. Okay, so what we can do, we can drop this term, all these terms can be dropped out, and only this term is left. Okay, so in that case, the total charge density QC prime is 2Q epsilon S Na. Signum psi S now becomes minus 1 because in accumulation the charge is positive charge. In accumulation region, the whole concentration is going to dominate over the electronic concentration. So signum psi becomes negative, so minus minus becomes positive. Then square root of 2q epsilon s Na, and in square root there is only one term left, which is phi t into e to the power minus psi s upon phi t. Okay, so this is the charge expression, and this can also be expressed in a little bit different form. Phi t can be taken here inside this square root, and e to the power minus psi s phi t can be written as e to the power psi s upon twice phi t. So here the QC prime, the charge density in the accumulation region is 2q epsilon s Na into phi t into e to the power minus psi s upon 2 phi t. So here we have a expression for the charge density QC prime in terms of surface potential, valid only in the accumulation region. Okay, if we are sure that get to body voltage VGV minus VFB is less than 0, then we can use this expression directly to compute the hole density at the silicon-silicon dioxide interface. Okay, in the second case, yeah, any question?
We have our next class from
12. Okay, okay, so let me stop here today. We'll continue this in the next class. Thank you very much.
Please do remind to share the PDF of previous lecture.
Okay, I will share this.
Sir, please share the previous one.